So we are going to find out quite soon that this class is very much three-dimensional. And as we start discussing stereochemistry, it will be important to be able to understand compounds and convert them from one structural representation to another. So one example is a Newman projection. And it will be valuable many times to be able to take a Newman projection and to then convert it into a line angle or a line wedge type drawing. So I'm going to show you in this video both an example of an anti-conformation and an eclipse conformation where we have to convert that into a line angle perspective. Okay, a line angle is going to have something like lines, wedges, and dashes that will give us three-dimensional perspective. And these line angle perspectives are very important for determining absolute configurations like R and S in stereochemistry. So I always take on a perspective where, imagine you are this eyeball sitting in the plane of the page, staring at this carbon-carbon bond, okay? And if you're staring at this carbon-carbon bond, okay, it's going into the page, the carbon that's coming out of the page or in front is on the left side of the viewer. And the carbon that's going into the page or behind the bond, the one we can't see that is represented by this circle, should be going to the right of the viewer. And any group that is pointed out towards the eyeball, fluorine and hydroxyl, are out of the page, or those are wedged. Any group that is going away from the eyeball, like hydrogen or deuterium, those are dashed or going into the page with respect to the eyeball. And then the groups that are planar, neither pointing towards or away from the eyeball, these are simply going to be lines, straight lines. So on the front carbon, there's an ethyl group that's going up above the eyeball. And anti to that is a chlorine on the back carbon going straight down. And if you think about the eyeball's vision, right, is this horizontal line here. We can see that the oxygen, which is attached to the front carbon, is sort of going down underneath this line. Or it's a wedge. We identify that because it's going towards the eyeball, but it's a wedge down. And the fluorine is above that horizontal line. It's a wedge, but it's up. Okay, so those two groups, fluorine and hydroxyl, which are gauched to one another, now you can know that those two wedges are gauche or staggered. All right, finally, the two dashes are the groups going away from the eyeball. Deuterium's on the front carbon and it's underneath this horizontal line. So the deuterium goes here. The hydrogen is on the back carbon and it's above that horizontal line. So it's a dash up. And so now what you can do is assign R and S. And we'll talk about problems where we go on to assign configuration once we reach stereochemistry. But for now, we should be able to go from a Newman projection, okay, to a line angle formula and back and forth. If you were to simply take your eyeball and look directly at the red carbon, it would produce this image. One more example with the eclipse conformation. So here I'll put some groups on this. We'll use the same substituents as before. Okay, so once again, if the eyeball is looking from this side, which is optional. You can look from either side, but you should just pick one and be consistent in your method. You can think about this as the line of sight, right? The oxygen and chlorine are both going towards the eyeball or wedged. The hydrogen and deuterium are going away from the eyeball or dashed. And then the planar lines, right, are just simply linear. So if you're producing the Newman projection, right, the front carbon, once again, it's coming out of the page or to the left of the eyeball. And we will view this horizontal bond where the back carbon is going into the page or to the right of the eyeball. And on the front and back carbon, there's one bond, right, pointing up. These are 0 degrees from one another. We have the ethyl on the front carbon and the fluorine on the back. Next, the hydroxyl and the chlorine are both wedged, and they're both going down underneath this horizontal line. OH on the front carbon and chlorine on the back. And then hydrogen and deuterium are both going down and dashed. Hydrogen on the back carbon, excuse me. Deuterium on the front. Okay, so it's the same process as the ante. We simply now have eclipsed lines, eclipsed wedges, and eclipsed dashes. So for more practice with converting Newman's to line angle formulas, you can visit unit 1 of my Orgo 1 course guide at chemguides.com.